Welcome, my dear friend. As in the last video, as we discussed the instruction and instruction sequencing basic, how that instructions will be get placed, two byte instruction, three byte instruction, single byte instruction. All these things we can discuss in the last previous video. In this video, how that instruction and instruction sequencing will be discussed, will be load, will work with the register that we have to discuss here. That using register. The register are register are more faster and shorter instruction. The number of register is smaller. For example, 32 register need 5 bits. The potential is the speed up. The minimum the frequency with which the data is moved back or and forth between the memory and the processor register. The instruction format. Instruction format is nothing but layout of the bits in the instructions, which include the opcode, that is operational code, and it also include implicit and explicit operand also. Usually, the more than one instruction format in an instruction set. The instruction length that was a very important concept, which is affected by the certain effect like a memory size, memory organization, bus structure, CPU complexity, and CPU speed. Then trade off between the powerful instruction report write. And saving the space also. Then allocations of the bits. Then allocations of the bits that will be on the basis of the number of addressing mode, then number of operands, then register versus memory, and the number of register sets, address range, address granularity, like that one. Here the format and different instruction types will be given here. Here the first the instruction format will be given. Here you can found that in the 16 bit. The 4 bits are to be specified only for the opcode, and remaining 12 bits are the given for the operand. So this is the instruction format. After that, in instruction types, here you can see that in instruction type, there are the first one in the first 3 byte instruction, that is the 3 addresses given, then 2 address instruction, single address instruction. Here the opcode memory address with the certain instruction. Here opcode relative address and memory address is given. Another is the opcode with relative address with numbers and zeros and ones. That so these are the different format of the different instruction types. Then we can take a simple example of that. Let us show how our simple computer can add two integers A and B and create a result as a C. We assume that integers are in the 2's complement format. Mathematically, we show this operation as C is equal to A plus B. We assume that the first two integers are stored in a memory location, that is 40 and 41, and the result should be stored in the memory location 42. To do the simple addition, we need a 5 instruction as shown in next. That are the steps, that is load the contained M40 into the register, that is R0 में पहले content लिया, load the contained M41 to the register R1, पहला data लिया R0 में, दूसरा data लिया R1 में. Next, add the content of R0 and R1 and place the result in R2. R0 और R1 की data को content को read add करो, और R2 में वो data store करो and store the content of R2 in M42 और बचा हुआ जो R2 का result है वो M42 में ready होने के बाद save कर दो and the halt and stop the process. In the language of our simple computer, these 5 instructions are encoded as first all these code are of a 16 bit, that is hexadecimal code. So code 1 for the first one 1040 is the address hai aur 16 bit ka 16 bit hexadecimal load R0 M40 R0 14 0 14 load 141 ADI 20 store 42 halt. In this way, this interpretation has to be done as per that. And here you can check the different instructions. We found that the complete details of that. Here the same things will be shown here as per the cycles diagrams. Okay, so this is status of cycle 1. In the first cycle, what you do, everyone check it. the first phase, what you do first, that program counter could contain 1040 Lilia. उसके बाद 1040 का डेटा ले लिया एंड आईआर में, आईआर की कंटेन भेज दिया मैंने R0 में, तो R0 में चला गया A1, R0 में चला गया A1, A1 का कंटेंट R0 में चला गया। ठीक, R0 में चला गया। देन स्टेटस फॉर साइकिल टू, fetch, decode, execute, then 1141 and next wala, next wale ko PC mein bheja, PC se bheja, uska content liya IR mein, usko M41 pe bheja, but 41 mein kya tha, 0FE, to dekhiye R1 mein 0FE aa gaya। status for cycle 3 mein kya hona tha ki addition execution honi wali thi, ये R0 और R1 की जो कंटेंट है 00A1 और 00FE, इन दोनों एक दूसरे के साथ ऐड होने वाले थे और उसका रिजल्ट R2 में स्टोर होने वाला था, तो उसका रिजल्ट R2 में स्टोर हो गया 0191 और प्रोग्राम काउंटर 1 से इंक्रीमेंट हो गया और IR में कितना आ गया 3201। स्टेटस फॉर साइकल्स 2, ऑपरेशन हो गया, सब कुछ हो गया, बट अभी जो R2 के कंटेंट जो है 19F वो ले लिए इधर F2 में, वो ले लिए 42 में ले लिया और प्रोग्राम काउंटर एक से और बढ़ा दिया और यहाँ पे 2422 लेके रह गए, 2 M42 है ना, तो M42 यहाँ पे रह गए, फिर M42 के R2 के अंडर M42 पे भेज दिया। स्टेटस फॉर साइकिल 4, हॉल्ट यानी स्टॉप करो यार, यहाँ पे 00 डाल दो। जैसे यहाँ पे 00 आ गया, हॉल्ट विलेज मैंने वहाँ पे एग्जीक्यूशन स्टॉप हो गया। ऐसे ही पांचों साइकल्स में ये हमारा ये जो पर्टिकुलर कंटेंट था वो वन बाय वन वर्क कर रहा था, पहले R0 में कंटेंट लिया, बाद में R1 में कंटेंट लिया, दोनों को एडिशन किए और वही R1 के R2 के कंटेंट हमने इसके M42 पे भेज दिया। इस हिसाब से पर्टिकुलर इंस्ट्रक्शन वन बाय वन एग्जीक्यूट होती है और उसका ऑपरेशन भी उस हिसाब से होता है। ओके, तो थैंक यू वेरी मच, नेक्स्ट पार्ट डिस्कस इन नेक्स्ट वीडियो।